Let's go to the White House. Kellyanne Conway, counselor to the president, joins us right now. Actually, she's at the bureau today. Hello, Kellyanne.
Good morning,
how are you?
We're doing
nice
okay.
To see you.
Hey, sounds like the talks on the border have broken down. And while they haven't been able to figure out how much money to give the president to build the wall, what the Democrats are asking is to reduce the number of ICE beds. And if you reduce the number of ICE beds, there has to be a bed for every person who is detained. That essentially is telling, the Democrats are telling the federal government how many people they can arrest, right?
No, it's true. And randomly choosing who should be caught and then released into the interior of the U.S. and who should remain there while their claims of asylum are being processed. And remember, Mexico has also offered a safe third option where you can remain in Mexico, have a work visa, have your humanitarian needs met while your claims of asylum are being processed on this side of the border. To defund ICE and to abolish ICE, as many prominent and big-mouth Democrats are asking for these days, would be devastating to our efforts to keep us all safe. So I'm glad you mentioned that, because the president is not part of these negotiations. He's waiting for a bill to come to his desk that he can sign into law, and you now have the conferees, bipartisan conferees, arguing over beds and barriers. But people should know, especially the people who went down to the border and complained that there weren't enough beds, we want more beds. They want fewer because they want more people to come into the United States of America. And everything else is on the table here, too. Look, I think the Democrats have had a horrible 6 weeks in 2019. They're the ones at the table now that can't get this done. They're the ones hurtling us towards a shutdown. They've got the top Democrat in Virginia is an accused racist. The second Democrat, the lieutenant governor in Virginia, is accused rapist, a difference of a letter. And they've got this congresswoman from Minnesota, again, having anti-Semitic sewage spilling from her mouth overnight.
Ilhan Omar.
And then you've got people running for president on the Green New Deal, 70% taxes, socialized medicine. They want to do away with cows. They want to do away with gas. They want to do away with cow gas and air travel. And they just, I mean, they've had a, they're sitting on their hands while the president is speaking against abortion in the 8th and 9th month, trying to stop human trafficking and sex trafficking. I mean, it's been a really terrible six weeks.
Well,
and we need a fully functioning Washington where both parties are focused on 2019 and not 2020.
Well, the president says that's why the Democrats, he thinks that they want to shut down the government, to change the narrative away from Virginia and what's happening, you know, tax 70% to 90%.
They certainly would own it, Ainslie, because everybody knows they're at the table now, and it's the legislative conferees, it's Congress. America already thinks Congress doesn't do its job very effectively. Look at their overall approval ratings, and this won't help them. I hope they will come to an agreement. The president called for bipartisanship, coming together on any number of issues just last Tuesday in his State of the Union. The first test of that is for these conferees to put on his desk a border security bill, immigration bill, that has in it a physical barrier as a centerpiece, but also includes all of these other issues about beds, ICE funding, humanitarian needs, new technology, more immigration judges, more Border Patrol agents, the full package. Let's see it.
Kellyanne, Beto O'Rourke's going to have a march and a rival rally to the president. Is the president concerned about the size of his crowds?
No, he's not concerned about that. And what I would say to them is, thanks for showing up. And if you really want to be on record, especially that guy who apparently wants to reward his loss of a Senate seat, his loss to Ted Cruz in Texas with running for president, let's just bring that to the whole country now, that being a loser. If he wants to remind everybody that he's against securing the border, a man who represented El Paso, then have at it. And I think every 2020 Democratic aspirant should be asked, do you agree with that? Do you agree that we don't need any type of physical barrier at our southern border? Do you agree with abortion anyone, anytime, anywhere? Do you agree with 70% taxes? Do you agree with Representative Omar of Minnesota when she's being anti-Semitic in her tweets? I think they should all be asked the same thing 24/7. Do you think Ralph Northam should stay? Do you think Justin Fairfax should stay? All these questions they should be asked. So if Beto O'Rourke shows up, he'll get a lot of camera time. He'll get free air time for his would-be 2020 race, and people should see that for what it is. The president is going down to El Paso and giving an interview to your colleague, Laura Ingraham at Fox News, for a reason. He wants to take the case directly to an area that would be affected positively if his view of legal and safe immigration and a physical barrier wall would come to fruition.
Well, you mentioned Beto O'Rourke maybe running for president. So far, we know that Amy Klobuchar declared over the weekend, as did Elizabeth Warren. You've got Kamala Harris. You've got Cory Booker. You've got former Congressman John Delaney. You've got Tulsi Gabbard, Andrew Yang, Julian Castro. That list is only 8 so far, but it could actually be 4 times that before it's all done.
Great. Keep it coming. Just remember, anything times 0 still equals 0. If you don't have good ideas that matter to the country, if you can't connect with people the way now President Trump did all through 2015 and 16, if people don't feel like you are giving them voice and visibility here in Washington, D.C., where it's going to be very difficult for a number of them to run as the outsider to President Trump, he's still seen as the outsider and disruptor, just somebody who's trying to make Washington work and trying to make Washington work in a better, more effective way. This is a country where 157 million Americans are working now under President Trump's leadership, the highest number ever. 58% of those new jobs have been filled by women.
Right.
This president is doing what he can to combat the opioid crisis, to get criminal justice reform in a way that people have paid their debt to society. He unified the nation last week just by having our D-Day veterans and a survivor of both the Holocaust, God bless him, Judah Samet, and also the Tree of Life massacre in Pittsburgh. He brought Grace there, a cancer survivor, sitting with the First Lady in her box. Why?
Gotcha.
So that Americans can feel good about the greatness of America. They've got nothing. They're so obsessed with Trump derangement
syndrome. Well, you want to hear some of it, Kellyanne? Here's some excerpts
so
you can comment specifically. We begin with Amy Klobuchar, go to Elizabeth Warren, then Cory Booker.
Every worker, farmer, dreamer, and builder, I am running for every American.
It won't be enough just to undo the terrible acts of this administration. Our fight is for big structural change.
People in America are losing faith. They're beginning to believe that too many folks are going to get left out. I'm running for president because I want to address these issues.
Well, to some, it's a binary choice, Kellyanne.
Yes, and that's why the president is likely to be reelected, because he will say, here's what I've done for the 3.5 years, by then the 4 years as president. Look at the economy. Look at how I'm trying to bring peace around the globe.
Right.
May not work with Chairman Kim, but this president's going to try it. Look what he's doing to renegotiate trade deals. Look, I'm yet to see presidential timber. I just see a bunch of presidential wood chips. And what happened this weekend is equally unimpressive. Amy Klobuchar, who seems to be a very nice person, I guess, unless you're on her staff. She's had some terrible articles about the way she treats him. I've always known her to be Minnesota nice. But you can change the A to an O and get Oh My instead of Amy there, because I don't think that was a very impressive rollout. It's a lot of sing-songy, happy talk from these folks. Or it's virulently anti-Donald Trump at all times. They're so obsessed with him. Nobody can physiologically begin or end a sentence, let alone an entire paragraph or campaign unveiling, without mentioning the president several times.
Right.
Elizabeth Warren spent decades, folks, decades, appropriating somebody else's heritage and ethnicity.
Yep.
And she's been lying about it. Kamala Harris is for the Green Deal. I think the other people have signed up. Kirsten Gillibrand this weekend in her 50s, apparently was the first time she's ever eaten fried chicken, and she waited for the cameras to roll. I mean, this is just silly stuff.
Let's get serious about the
major issues that attend to here. By the way, let me give some credit to Mike Bloomberg and Howard Schultz. These are two guys who started businesses out of nothing, and they have successfully been job creators and have operated within the private insurance system for decades for their employees, and they're against the Green New Deal. They know this is stupid.
They both have very good credit and are very rich.
They can't beat Donald Trump.
Right.
But at least they're pushing
Axios
back.
Axios is reporting over the weekend that the president is working on meeting with President Xi at Mar-a-Lago, Can you move this story forward?
No, it's possible. In fact, the president had the letter from President Xi read out loud about 10 days ago when the vice premier was here for a wonderful Oval Office meeting. I happened to be in there. There's some of the clips from the last meeting. And he wants to meet with President Xi very soon. You know that March 1st deadline is approaching. The president knows that his trade policies and the tariffs are working. He also wants President Xi to make good on the promise to schedule fentanyl as a controlled substance.
Are they getting closer to a deal, Kellyanne?
It looks that way, absolutely. And yes, this president wants a deal. He wants it to be fair to Americans, American workers, and American interests. He has forged a mutually respectful relationship with President Xi, and the trade team led by Ambassador Lighthizer has been working overtime to get this deal done. The president remains the same, exactly what he's been saying all along. Why do we have a $500 billion trade deficit with China? Why are our folks the ones getting screwed? But he wants to, of course, do trade with China. He just wants it to be fair to this country. But they've got a great relationship. They will meet again soon.
We would all love to hear a deal breakthrough.
The biggest economies.
Keep us posted. All right, Kellyanne.
And you know that President Trump, of course, at the end of this month is meeting again with Chairman Kim in Vietnam.
That's right.
Trying to push forward the denuclearization in North Korea. He's a busy guy.
No kidding. All right,
thanks, Kellyanne.
Executive time abroad. You got it.